Oke, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome back with me, Ali Putra Alika. Here I'm going to talk about NGN policies challenge. Oke, so what is NGN policy? So basically, NGN policy is policy that talk about NGN. Generally, it divided into two parts. The first one is general policy that contain consistent competition policy, migration strategy, explore government incentive, local content policy, implementation of USO, etc. Next, we got technical regulation, where it contain interconnection, tarif, numbering, QoS, security, standardization, interoperability, migration of IPv4 to IPv6. So, there are also regulator that regulate the policy in Indonesia. KPI will used to work as service regulator that check the content provided by the provider and Ministry of Education and Information. As the network regulator that check the network that has been provided from the provider. Next, we got the NGN policy issue. Okay, talking about first, talking about issue must be economic issue. As we know, for the economic, normally provider have go to war price between each provider, giving a cheaper product for price competition. But normally, as the price is lower, the quality is decreased. Next, we got access issue. As Indonesia have three rural area that we also call treaty, tertinggal, terluar, dan terdepan. There's still a lot of place that can access the NGN. Next, we got interconnection. Normally, we're using a switch network. But here for the NGN, we're using IP-based network. So what is the solution? Okay, for the economic problem, we got adjustment to economic regulation where we have to set a limit for a product so the quality will not decrease. Next, for access, we got fiberization. So rural area can also use fiber optic that the same as the city. And also we got fiber to the home, just like we're using Wi-Fi at home. Next, also, we got USO or so-called the universal service obligation. That means that operator provide a minimum set of service to all user regardless their geographical location within the national territory at affordable price, even though there may be significant difference in cost of supply. So, for example, in USA, there is a discount for internet quota for school and libraries. In Canada, there are price subsidies for remote area. In Switzerland, is maximum price of 50 euro at remote area. And in Indonesia, we got Bakti for conducting telecommunication service in remote area. Okay, maybe that's all from me. Thank you for watching this video. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.